I don't care if I just uploaded a video a couple hours ago. We just finished the Black Magic event and they just came out swinging. If you can't tell, I'm really excited about everything that was announced today. Especially in the past year, I have been saying that, you know, RIP Adobe, even though I still give them my money every month because certain clients just gotta have Premiere. I personally think Adobe, don't care how much hate I get for this, dumpster fire trash of a pro editing software. There, I said it. I know a ton of people use it. I know it probably works great for your workflow, and that's awesome for you, but man, it is the most frustrating piece of crap software that is also the most expensive, so make that make sense. Well, this year, I think a lot more people are gonna be switching over to Resolve, especially now that we have Resolve 18. Literally just went live moments ago. It is downloading on my computer right behind the camera. The public beta is available, both free and paid version. And before we get into what my favorite features of today's event was, I want to talk about what Grant started talking about in the beginning of the event, which was all about Black Magic culture and kind of their mantra. And they definitely took shots at Adobe without saying the name. But he was talking about these big tech companies make you pay these crazy large subscription fees because that's where investment money's at. You also get locked into that. A lot of people don't realize that, you know, I pay $50 a month for Adobe, but unlike Netflix that I can just log in and cancel if, you know, work's not going great and I need to cut some costs somewhere, no, you're locked into a 12-month contract. So if you go in, try to cancel your monthly Adobe membership, they're gonna make you pay out that whatever remaining amount is. And just in case you don't realize, Blackmagic Studio, the $300 software, basically I have never bought because I've bought so many Blackmagic cameras. Each one of their products comes with a studio license. Bought my production 4K, here's the license. Pocket 4K, Pocket 6K, Pocket 6K Pro, Speed Editor, eGPU. If their products are relevant to editing or cameras, you basically get a 2-seat license to the full DaVinci Resolve Studio. And every time they come out with a new version every year or so, it's a free upgrade. So I've shared so many licenses with so many friends. I feel like the Oprah of DaVinci Resolve licenses. And so with something like their new cloud store services, that's gonna be $5 a month. It is $5 a month for the host. Anyone you share it with is free and there's no long-term contract. And he literally told us on the live stream how to get out of that $5 if you really want to by just exporting the project file out of the cloud. And then you can turn off the cloud service if, again, you're having an off month or, you know, work's not going that great. So I know this was kind of a rant to begin with, but in addition to all the amazing pieces of software and new features that they release, I love standing behind a company who it genuinely feels like they're not trying to screw over their customer base or sell off their data or squeeze every single dollar amount out of. All right, let's get into the meat of this video talking about DaVinci Resolve 18. All right, there was so much jam-packed into this event, way more than I expected. So we're gonna divide this into two groups. We have the Blackmagic cloud stuff and then DaVinci Resolve 18. I'm only gonna talk about the cloud stuff for a minute because you guys can go deep dive into which part of the cloud is more interesting. And there was so much technical knowledge that I don't think is, that I'm not an expert on because I literally just heard it 30 minutes ago. But I just want to share kind of the overarching idea in case you missed the event. So they released a bunch of new projects. Basically, you have this new Blackmagic Cloud Store, which uses the same housing as the eGPU. Looks awesome. But instead of a GPU, it's filled with a ton of M.2 SSDs. And you can get anywhere from like 20 to 320 terabytes of cloud storage. That is the most expensive model. That is for significantly larger production workflows because I think it starts at around 9 or 10 grand. But again, not only for the pro pros, they work with smaller content creators. So they released the Cloud Store Mini for $3,000, which is this 8 terabyte high performance, basically gives you all the same features of the larger one, just in a smaller form factor and smaller storage space. and they basically partnered with Dropbox to use their sync technology. And the ultra simplified version of what these things are doing is it's essentially a NAS storage system where you can put all your projects, your files, everything on there. And then if you have multiple people working in your studio, everyone can access it like a normal server. But since it's all that Blackmagic workflow, it just is going to work so seamlessly. And there's one more version of the cloud products, and that's the Cloud Pod, a even more cost-effective option than the other two. For $395, $400, you essentially get all the hardware that you need to have the cloud component, but you essentially bring your own drive. So it has a couple USB-C ports on the back, and you can plug in like a Samsung T5 drives that we shoot directly on. Now, the only thing I think I was missing while watching all this cloud stuff is I kept waiting for them to talk about like, oh, and you can buy these different storage tiers, you know, how you buy Adobe storage or iCloud storage or Google Drive storage. I thought there was going to be like a cloud storage where you could put files to basically store them on there. But the more I thought about it, it makes sense. Either that's something they're going to do in the future, and this is kind of just a starting point, which is fair. But I also kind of understand them not doing that, because when you work on these bigger project files, you have to download them locally anyway to actually edit. And so this is a way to have two people who are working remotely. They each individually have their own storage solutions. And this is a new system and workflow to make it really easy to share constantly multi-user project files and keep everyone updated and in the same loop. So again, if you want to dig into their whole cloud workflows, depending on the size of your productions and how many people are on your team, definitely go to Blackmagic's site because they have all the resources, rewatch the event. But for now, let's dive into DaVinci Resolve 18, talk about some of the standout features that they showed in the event, and then I'm sure there's going to be some that they didn't have time to talk about, but maybe we'll see on their site. And all right, so one of the things that is funny when you go to Resolve 18's new website is they have all like the chapter markers at the top, what's new, edit, cut page, all the pages and stuff. That used to be just a handful. Now the text is so small because they have so many features packed into this one piece of software. I've said it 1,000 times, I'm gonna say it again. Everyone talks about the Adobe Creative Suite and how there's so many apps. Resolve is basically all of those apps in one. I recently made a joke to like TikTok and Twitter video that showcased how like when you right click in Premiere to open a After Effects composition, hey, you're essentially waiting a couple of minutes just for After Effects to open up, to set up the project, to save it in the same place, and then you have to change complete programs to go back. It's just so much more hassle than it needs to be. Resolve, you literally just click a different tab and it's like you're in a whole new program, but it's all the same program. We have the cloud collaboration, which I talked about. Obviously, it's now built into DaVinci Resolve 18. So if you've got someone colorizing clips while you're editing, you can actually see what the colorist is doing. They showed that they added a very cool, in the timeline viewer, there's gonna be a little refresh like tag in the top right-hand corner. If you wanna see what the updated like grade or edit from a remote editor would look like, tap that and it's gonna update so you can see it. The Blackmagic Proxy Generator is gonna be a separate piece of software that comes with Resolve 18. If you are tired of always having to create proxies when you import footage, you essentially can take the manual labor out of it. You essentially set up a watch folder. So maybe you are always putting them on the same drive or within the same like YouTube projects folder and you put all your videos in there. As soon as it senses new media, it will generate proxies for that automatically. So that way, when you go to actually open up Resolve and start editing, your proxies are already ready to go. As someone who loves color grading and that whole process and learning to get better at it, there were some awesome standout features on the color page. The object mask, whoo, looks very similar to what is in After Effects. And again, they just smushed right on past After Effects. No need for a separate program. You essentially just draw a line on an object and it's going to sense it. You track it and the tracking looked really good. It also has add and subtract. So if you need to make multiple selections in order to track a whole object, because maybe something's in front of it or obscuring the view, you can add and subtract selections. Trap moving warp surfaces. This was really cool. They basically showed off a graphic tee with some lettering on the back, and how one, you can use that text as different tracking points to then overlay another logo, like the Resolve logo they showed off in the event. Or if you need to blur things out due to like copyright infringement or trademarking, or maybe you need to blur brands out, they also showed how you can just use it as a mask to then add another effect like mosaic blur. On the edit page, multicams, thanks to, I'm gonna say a lot has to do with optimization of the software, especially on Apple's M1 machines. You can now have up to 25 simultaneously multicam angles. I have no need for that, but it looked absolutely trippy. It's not listed on the website here, but I believe they also added a new quick export where you can create quick export settings. You also can create a new preset for default new projects. This sounds so small, but it's so huge to me. As normally I'm always doing YouTube videos, I like to keep pretty much the same settings for almost every video. And so every time I open a new project, I have to go from 1080p to 6K. I change the image scaling to scale with crop. I change my cache locations. So now hopefully with that, create a new default preset, I'll be able to open up Resolve and just automatically be able to jump in and start editing a lot faster. Fusion, it seems like they basically just made huge improvements to the overall speed and real-time playback. Now, I am not an advanced Fusion user doing all like the 3D painting out stuff, but I do use Fusion titles quite a bit, and that has been the biggest pain point in Resolve for me. And why I don't use graphics more is even with a very powerful computer, I've always had to render the cache out because the playback has always been a little buggy. And a lot of times even scrubbing through to find a graphic you like, sometimes the playback's really smooth and sometimes it's a little laggy. And so they've made huge improvements here. I hope to confirm that once I get on the computer. Fairlight, I'll be 100% honest with you. I do just a minimal amount of dialogue processing in my videos, but you can do some what seems to be very impressive things in there. And then some other random features that were just kind of like, oh, that's pretty cool. I don't know if I'll have an application for it, but the atmospheric simulation, we have all downloaded those like, you know, asset packs that come with like some stock footage of smoke or fog or something. Then you put it over top your layer, you change the blending mode to screen. The problem with that is it never actually tracks with your footage, right? During the keynote, they actually showed a clip where you could actually see the atmosphere move and track with the footage. And so I'm not gonna say it looks like the most realistic thing ever. I'm sure they could have dialed it in a bit better, but definitely a step in the right direction and kind of a cool showcase to do simulations in real time in an editor is really cool. Optimized for M1 Ultra. A lot of people are saying Resolve is running better than even Final Cut. Looks like they got some super scale features, a person mask, some new style options, smart reframe for social media. I don't think they talked about that in the keynote. So it's literally what Premiere got updated with last year, where it will kind of pick a 9x16 and kind of intelligently look at where the subject is in a 16x9 frame. Awesome. The other feature that's not on here that I think will be super useful, the despill, I believe it was called. If you're in an environment like green screen or even anywhere that's throwing off just a major hue that's spilling onto your subject, that a lot of times kind of ruins skin tones in color grading, this despill feature should eliminate whatever the hue is, whether it's magenta, green, or anything. There's so much. And I'm sure once I start diving into it, I'm gonna find all the features that they didn't talk about in the keynote. But let me know what you guys thought about the events down in the comments down below. I know this is probably gonna be a little bit longer of a video. I'll try to cut it down from the 30 minutes that it currently is while I'm recording. They just jam-packed so much into this. If you've never tried Resolve, I highly recommend just downloading the free version. Like I said, it works the exact same way as the paid version. It has the majority of the features, and just play with it for like one project or a couple of hours. And I really think when you compare the price point and the features that this has, that it pretty much has every feature, especially now that Adobe Premiere has, and in my opinion, does it way better. Feel free to argue with me down in the comments. All right, that's two videos in one day. I'm gonna go, work on my Blackmagic Pocket 6K Pro 1 year later video that's coming out later this week. hopefully. Thanks so much for watching. See you guys in the next video.